Magandang araw muli sa inyong lahat. Welcome sa ating channel, Sir Lopez Vlog. Sa araw na ito ay magkakaroon muli tayo ng self-evaluation dito sa subject na institutional correction. 25 katanungan ang susukat sa inyong academic preparation pagdating sa subject na ito at ang mga kasagutan ay makikita lamang dito sa ating description box. Okay, kung nakahanda na kayo, start na natin sa question number 1.
What is the tour of duty of the director and the deputy directors of the Bucor? Letter A, 2 years. Letter B, 4 years. Letter C, 6 years. Or letter D, 8 years. Number 2. Ancient form of punishment wherein the offender was putting away and which was carried out either by prohibition against coming into a specified territory such as an island to where the offender has been removed. Letter A, banishment or exile. Letter B, death penalty. Letter C, physical torture. Or letter D, transportation and slavery. Number 3. What is the ratio of custodial personnel to inmate? A, 1:1+1. B, 1:7. C, 7:1. Or letter D, 1:4. Number 4. What kind of punishment is referring to the form of group vengeance wherein the purpose is to appease the offended public or group? A, deterrence. B, imprisonment. C, death penalty. Or letter D, expiation or atonement. Number 5. Who will make the appointment of Corrections Officer 1 to Corrections Chief Superintendent? Letter A, Director General of Corrections. Letter B, President. Letter C, DOJ Secretary. Or letter D, Member of the Senate. Number 6. The BJMP is under the Department of letter A, DOJ. Letter B, DILG. Letter C, DSWD. Or letter D, DND. Number 7. This is referring to a redress that the state takes against an offending member of society that usually involves pain and suffering. A, imprisonment. B, punishment. C, rehabilitation. Or letter D, reformation. Number 8. Refers to the highest officer in Bucor with the rank of undersecretary as a civilian employee in the uniform service. Letter A, Director General. Letter B, Bucor Superintendent. Letter C, Police General. Or letter D, Bucor Colonel. Number 9. The study and practice of a systematic management of jails or prisons and other institutions concerned with the custody, treatment, and rehabilitation of criminal offenders. Letter A, Correctional Administration. Letter B, Correction. Letter C, Penology. Or letter D, Reformation. Number 10. Who has general supervision and control of all national prisons or penitentiaries? Letter A, Office of the President. Letter B, Supreme Court. Letter C, Bureau of Corrections. Or letter D, Bureau of Jail Management and Penology. 11. a person committed to jail or prison by a competent authority for any of the following reasons except letter A, to serve a sentence after conviction, letter B, trial, letter C, investigation, or letter D, punishment. Number 12, the type of ship used for transportation of criminals in the 16th century. Letter A, gull. Letter B, galley. Letter C, hook. Or letter D, ordeal. Those sentenced to suffer a term of sentence of 3 years and 1 day to life imprisonment are called letter A, insular or national prisoners, letter B, provincial prisoners, letter C, city prisoners, or letter D, none of them. 14. This act shall be known as the Bureau of Corrections Act of 2013. Letter A, Republic Act 57-510. Letter B, Republic Act 10-57-5. Letter C, Republic Act 75-10-5. Letter D, Republic Act 83-53. 15. This is referring to the assigning or grouping of inmates according to their sentence, gender, age, nationality, health, criminal records, etc. Letter A, classification. Letter B, commitment. Letter C, mitimos. Or letter D, arrangement. 16. A warrant issued by the court bearing its seal in the signature of the judge directing the jail or prison authorities to receive the convicted offender for service of sentence or detention. A. Classification. B. Commitment. Letter C. Mitimos. Or letter D. Arrangement. 17. Under the law, the head of the Bureau Corps with the rank of Under-Secretary shall have the position and title of blank. Letter A, Corrections Chief Superintendent. Letter B, Chief Superintendent. Letter C, Deputy Directors of Corrections. Or letter D, Director General of Corrections. 18. The task given to jail or prison administrators and custodial force personnel to secure the entire establishment. A. Security. B. Reformation. Letter C. Rehabilitation. Or letter D. All of them. 19. Rewards for good conduct or behavior whereby a prisoner receives partial remission or reduction of his sentence. Good conduct time allowance. B. Good behavior deduction. C. Both A and B. Or letter D. Credit for good conduct. 20. To convert or induce another to change his religious belief or sect. A. Proselytizing. B. Diagnostic treatment. C. Six deviates. Or letter D. None of them. 21. What is referring to a person who was detained for investigation, preliminary hearing, or awaiting trial? A. Detention prisoners. B. Person deprived of liberty. Letter C. Prisoners who are safekeeping. Or letter D. national prisoners. The study of punishment for crime or of criminal offenders. It includes the study of control and prevention of crime through punishment or criminal offenders. A. Correctional administration. B. Jail management. C. Penology. Or letter D. Penal administration. A branch of the criminal justice system concerned with the custody, supervision, and rehabilitation of criminal offenders. Letter A, Bureau. Letter B, Penology. Letter C, Correction. Or letter D, Reformation. 24. The concept of personal revenge by the victim's family or tribe against the family or tribe of the offender. Hence, blood feuds was accepted in the early primitive societies. Letter A, redress. Letter B, fines and punishment. Letter C, retaliation. Or letter D, none of them. 25. What is referring to a place for locking up of person who are convicted of minor offenses? A. Prison. B. Lock up. C. Hospital. Or letter D. Jail.
So natapos na natin ang ating sinagawang self-evaluation sa araw na ito. Maraming salamat sa pakikibahagi sa ating sinasagawang pagsasanay para sa preparation ninyo for the board examination. Okay, so maraming salamat again. Magandang araw po sa inyong lahat. See you again next time.